Hey guys, welcome back to today's video. Recently, we did a teardown video of the Enphase IQ7 Plus microinverter. You can click the corner to check that. And today we got our hands on another model, the IQ8X. So without further ado, let's take it apart to check out its internal components. It adopts a black plastic shell with a matte design, and there are many irregular protrusions and depressions on the back corresponding to the internal components. All the specs info is printed here. The off-grid power factor range is plus minus 1, and the grid tied one is plus minus 0.85. The maximum continuous AC output is 315 volt amp, and the maximum continuous DC input power is 588 watts. The operating temperature is negative 40 degrees Celsius to 60 degrees Celsius with IP67 ingress protection. It also has passed UL certification. You can pause here to take a look at the details. Flip to this side. The AC output port is on the left and the DC input port is on the right side. An indicator light is in the middle. The size of the microinverter is about 21 by 12 by 3 cm and the weight is about 932 grams. Next, let's open the case and check out the internal components and structure. Use a spudger to pry along the gap. Then heat it up with a heat gun. Remove the case. It's filled with massive black silicone adhesives for sealing and heat dissipation. Clean up the adhesives. Then let's introduce the major components. There are four capacitors on the left and the inverter transformer is at the top. The low voltage MOSFET for boosting and the corresponding driver are on the bottom, and two circuits for output filtering and power line communication are on the right, and no components on the back. These four DC capacitors are used for input filtering. They are from Rubycon ZLH series, which are connected in parallel, 80 volts, 1500 microfarad. This inductor is also used for input filtering. The master controller is from Enphase, which controls the boost and output modulation. And the external crystal oscillator of the controller is below it, 25 MHz. The 8 MB memory is from Winbond. This buck chip is from Texas Instruments, which is a wide voltage input converter that supports 95 volts input and 350 mA output. And those two smaller chips on the left are also from Texas Instruments. There are synchronous buck converters that support 17 volts input and 2M output, and adopt SOT23 package. The dual voltage comparator is from Texas Instruments, which is used for protection and detection. Here is a chip customized by Enphase, which can communicate with the power line. These 7 MLCC filter capacitors are used for DC input and connected in parallel. Those four MOSFETs are from AOS and can form an H-bridge for DC input. 80 volts, 2.2 mm for each one. This is a 100 volts half-bridge driver from MPS. Here is the other one. The big circular inverter transformer is from APCOS and integrates the output current mutual inductance, and the output insulated wires goes through it. The four output modulating MOSFETs are from Infineon and adopt TOLL package, 650 volts, 102 mm. Those two dual-channel isolated drivers are from Texas Instruments, which are used to modulate the drive for MOSFETs. This is a 0.33 microfarad safety X2 capacitor. The common mode choke is composed of two small parts in red and copper color. And this varistor between them is from APCOS SNF 14 series, which is used for output overvoltage protection. This is another 0.33 microfarad safety X2 capacitor. The upper fuse next to it is from Little Fuse, 3.15 amp, 300 volts. Here is another same common mode choke. And this is yet another 0.33 microfarad safety X2 capacitor. This little discharge transistor next to it is connected in series with a varistor that prevents overvoltage. The output varistor is from APCO's SNF14 series. These are two upper Y capacitors. The transformer next to it is used to modulate power line communication. Well, that's all components of this Enphase IQ8X microinverter. After taking it apart, we found its internal design is nearly identical to the IQ7 Plus, and the major components are from top-tier brands like APCO's, Texas Instruments, Infineon, etc. Besides, the massive silicon adhesives can make it perform great in severe weather. So, in terms of product quality, the IQ8X is just as good as IQ7 Plus. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye!